Hey guys, Janus here. In today's video, I want to talk specifically about arteriogenesis. Behind me here, I've drawn a lengthwise cross-section of an artery. In this example, I'm going to explain how shear stress causes a generation of vascular endothelial growth factor and platelet-derived growth factor. Now, as many of you already know, the innermost lining of our blood vessels, known as the glycocalyx, these hairs right here, are tantamount to sensing the flow of blood and ensuring that endothelial cells appropriately respond to increases in that rate of flow with increased dilation. Starting off, we're going to focus our attention along this artery's central channel. As we perform the angiogram methods, blood flow through our arteries increases dramatically, and this heightened level of shear stress caused by that increased rate of flow along the walls of an artery causes endothelial cells to begin releasing a greater amount of nitric oxide in response. After this increase in nitric oxide output occurs, the blood vessel opens to essentially its maximal diameter. It is in the minutes to hours following this increase in flow that endothelial cells begin to produce the chemical vascular endothelial growth factor, VEGF for short, that causes a more aggressive form of endothelial ultrastructure activation and signals them to begin migrating outwardly into the surrounding tissue masses of the artery. As this is occurring, a secondary set of growth factors and chemoattractants are formed by endothelial cells, chief among these being PDGF subtype BB, and this occurs along the central channel of the blood vessel where the greatest amount of shear stress is being experienced. As platelet-derived growth factor subtype BB, also known as PDGF BB, is released into the walls and areas closest to the center of the blood vessel, smooth muscles sense this increased level of PDGF-BB and begin migrating from the outer layers towards the center to expose themselves to the heightened area of shear stress, therefore causing a neo-intimal layer formation. This, coupled with immune cells helping to break down the collagen support structures of blood vessel walls to help not only facilitate the migration of smooth muscles to the central channel of the blood vessel, it also helps to increase the rate at which smooth muscles proliferate due to a greater amount of smooth muscles being able to migrate towards the center and be exposed to PDGF and more of the stretching forces inherent to blood pulses being exerted upon the smooth muscles instead of the collagen support structures. Okay, full disclosure here real quick. Even though I would love to be able to draw and show the migration of smooth muscles and the neo-intimal layer formation and the collagen support structure breakdown, it really is just way beyond my artistic ability. So this week, I'm going to try and find pictures that I believe paint the most accurate picture of what's going on and share those in a community post so that way you guys can get a more in-depth idea of what all's going on. After the generation of the neo-intimal layer consisting of the newly made smooth muscles, the next step is an outward migration of those smooth muscles facilitated by the endothelial ultrastructure that exists inside the blood vessel walls, these structures in through here. Whether it is through the center of an endothelial cell channel or by means of winding around the endothelial tubules, the literature is somewhat unclear, smooth muscles begin to travel away from the center of the blood vessel. Now, at this stage, there's a point that I want everyone to really grasp onto, really understand. After the formation of the neo-intimal layer, the most pivotal factor regarding blood vessel remodulation, this being the eventual widening of a blood vessel through smooth muscle migration, is nitric oxide. The key element to arteriogenesis is nitric oxide. Without elevated levels of nitric oxide, the newly formed neo-intimal layer of an artery cannot successfully migrate away from the center of a blood vessel. Instead, it remains trapped there, which leads to an eventual narrowing of an artery through inward instead of outward remodeling. The number one way to ensure that this does not happen is to eat in a fashion that preserves and protects the glycocalyx. This means keeping an eye on sodium levels, avoiding sugar, avoiding fried foods, and eating in line with a more plant-based lifestyle. Even though this is somewhat of a peek into the world of blood vessel remodeling, I hope it helps everyone to better understand not only shear stress, but some of the steps involved in adaptation. Understanding the principles I've laid out in this video will be very important to our discussions with future topics such as stretch and pressure-based exercise applications. Well guys, that's it for this video. As we progress through the Builder series, we will have need of a much more in-depth understanding of arteriogenesis, but for now, what I've discussed in this video will help address some of everyone's more immediate questions. Also, some of you may already know this, but currently I've been spending what little free time I can find doing a bit of R&D. As of right now, I have a working prototype that I plan to unveil to my subscribers in the coming months after I've done a bit more refining. Currently, while the prototype is effective, its overwhelming power has made it difficult to use properly, and I'm at somewhat of a sticking point because of that. Something I'd like to discuss here at the end. As a bit of incentive to you, my audience, I'm going to make a pledge. For every 1,000 subscribers to my channel, up to 10,000, and then every 10,000 from there, I plan on doing a special invention video where I take the concepts I've discussed on my channel thus far and make prototypes based on them. In those videos, I'll be breaking down how to make them in step-by-step instructional videos where you get to follow along in a play-by-play fashion of the action. Lastly, when the channel gains speed and breaks 5,000 subscribers, I plan on incorporating a research proposal aspect to my channel where I use polls at the start of my videos to let you have a say in the future of my channel as a collective through voting. Well guys, thanks for tuning in, and as always, I'll see everyone next Sunday. And I'm your host, Janus, signing off.